नमस्कार, प्रोफेसर ओपीएस नेगी, ऑनरेबल वाइस चांसलर उत्तराखंड ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी हल्द्वानी, प्रोफेसर मधु परहर डायरेक्टर सीएमसीए, प्रोफेसर दुर्गेश पंत कन्वीनर ऑफ द वर्कशॉप, डॉक्टर जितेंद्र पांडे कोऑर्डिनेटर ऑफ द वर्कशॉप, ऑल द डेलीगेट्स फ्रॉम बांग्लादेश श्रीलंका एंड इंडिया, faculty members, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me immense pleasure to inaugurate the workshop on a highly relevant topic, COVID-19, technology to reach and teach the learners today. And thank Professor Negi for inviting me to this occasion. Friends, we all know that COVID-19 has taken a heavy toll on all walks of life globally. During lockdown period, in most parts of the world, including India, educational institutions have been closed. In India alone, more than 32 crore students have been affected. Globally, this pandemic has changed the way people live, behave, and act. Social distancing or physical distancing has become the new norm. But we have to have resilience to fight it and keep moving towards making our planet a better place to live. This complex and volatile situation provides us newer opportunities also. We know for sure that this entire human civilization more or less hinges around education and the value system that we transfer from one generation to another. In this context, I am very happy to know that the School of Computer Science and IT and Vocational Studies of Uttarakhand Open University, in collaboration with Commonwealth Educational Media Center for Asia, New Delhi, is organizing a 5-day workshop especially pertaining to the online tools which are required for dissemination of online education and has become indispensable in the wake of COVID-19. I extend my compliments to Uttarakhand Open University and the collaborating institution for this endeavor. It is important during these days of social distancing that our system embraces digital teaching learning methods comprehensively and develop an academic ecosystem in which our learners and teachers could be in sync with the technological tools and techniques. When face-to-face engagement is to be avoided, technology can provide us a platform through which learners and teachers could not only be benefited, but they could also make use of the best available teaching learning resources. With the digital web, the knowledge boundaries are thinning, and the learner, wherever he or she is, has an opportunity to get the best of the contents from the best of the teachers at his or her own learning pace, place, and time. The power of technology has diminished many boundaries and at the same time accelerated the teaching learning process. This is the other side of COVID-19. It is in this context that this digital workshop assumes greater significance. I have also got to know that it covers various topics like Google tools, CMS, LMS, etc., which are very important for teachers, researchers, and learners. You all would be happy to know that the UGC has taken a number of measures to meet the challenges arising out of the COVID-19. To ensure uninterrupted teaching and learning at home and minimize academic loss by leveraging the potential of ICT, UGC advised the universities to shift to online mode of teaching during the lockdown period. It also shared with universities the links of digital platforms developed by MHRD and UGC to create awareness among the academic fraternity. The universities are being encouraged to make use of ICT initiatives like SWAYAM online courses, UG PG MOOCs, EPG Pathshala, SWAYAM Prabha, CEC UGC YouTube channel, National Digital Library, Shodh Ganga, eShodh Sindhu, and Vidwan database, etc. It is truly heartening to see that the traffic on the SWAYAM portal has increased multifold during these days. UGC has also notified open-end distance learning and online regulations. And as of now, 128 universities for 1,592 ODL programs and 7 universities for 37 online programs have been recognized by UGC. As of now, a total of around 45 lakh learners are enrolled under ODL mode. The online education is likely to get a further boost with the recent announcement of Honorable Finance Minister and also to permit top 100 universities to offer online programs. A number of suggestions have been received under Bharat Padhe online campaign, which was launched by our Honorable Minister for Human Resource Development, Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Ji Nishank. Thus, the share of online education is going to increase soon. And workshop like this will prove of great help to popularize this mode, since the success of technology-enabled education depends on the capacity building of our faculty members. In the end, I congratulate all the participants and the organizers, Uttarakhand Open University and Commonwealth Educational Media Center for Asia. I do hope that Uttarakhand Open University and the Commonwealth Educational Media Center for Asia will keep developing better and enriching models and techniques to facilitate large number of learners who definitely deserve better quality education in the wake of COVID-19 and in the post-COVID era. I wish you all healthy and safe living. I wish the workshop a grand success and great learning time for all the participants. Thank you and Jai Hind.